What's going on, everybody out there in YouTube land and the internet? I'm Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiPlatGameTrack.com, and I'm going to do a video on how I record my gameplay, and I'm not going to show you techniques on certain things, but I'm going to show you the applications I do use and the hardware I use to record gameplay or just in general anything that has to do with gaming or anything off my console. So here goes, nothing. All right, that is my desktop that I use, because I use a Mac, and I use the Hopog, and this is the Hopog HD PVR, and this is the US version of it. They have a UK version for PAL, and I use that. Then I use another hardware source I do use. This is to record in-game commentary. They have another two-channel version of this. It's cheaper. This one costs about $60. The other one's like $30 or $20. And then you see all the little cables back here. And that's the mic that I use. I'll show you that in a second. Then to split the audio into the mixer, I use these little cords. They're both little female jacks right there. And they have two females on each side, and then it goes into here. Then it runs, and it goes right in there. Then it comes back out, and it goes back into the Hopog right there on the back. And then from there, it goes, as you can see, into my TV. And then I'll show you the little mic that I use. It's a lapel mic. It's an omnidirectional lapel mic from Audio Technica. And this is basically it right there. It's turned on and goes right there, straps onto your thing. I actually hook it up right onto my Astros, the mic on my Astros, and then it sits right in front of my mouth and it makes for a good recording. Then the hardware I use is I got a Mac Pro 1.1 with 9 gigs of RAM. I got a Radeon HD 5770 in there, and I have another NVIDIA card in there too. And then I use, for Mac users, we have to buy another application after you buy the Hopog. Can't use the one that it comes with unless you're running boot camp. And basically, this is the program right here. It's pretty easy. Ooh, let me back up. And I'll just zoom in. All right, zooming in. All right, just show you real quick. And it always goes back to this 1600 kilobytes a second, but I raise it up to 1700, and I leave it at a constant bit rate. So that's 14 megabytes per second, if you're gonna do the math. Then AAC, two channel, then it re-encodes it and puts it as an MP4. It records this and it makes it a FLV file, but then it repackages it and puts it as a MP4 file. Then those are the values I have everything set up as. And I do that, so I don't have to do none of that post-processing, post-editing, color correction. And this is basically nothing really. Alright. Then once that's done, I use three different type of apps to do my editing. Depending on how I want the editing done, I can use, let's see, iMovie app, and I'll just open that one up real quick. What other app do I use? Let's see, that's iMovie right there. And as you see, got my intros and have a little project, you know, by the default name. These are my little intros. And a couple of intros I did for somebody else. And y'all recognize that. That's what you're gonna see at the beginning of this. And it's where you basically do all the capturing what part of the clips you want. And then I'm starting to use Adobe Premiere Pro CS5. And to encode everything, I use Adobe Media Encoder CS5 with this program, this application, or program, or however you want to call it. And it's just going to ask me. Show you beta test. And actually, it's missing a file right now because I deleted it. But it's basically the same thing as iMovie. It's just a lot more. It runs in 64-bit and a lot faster when you're rendering the image. But you can see right here in the corner, that's my watermark. And right here is my watermark. And since I recorded my commentary live, it will be in this. This is actually the video piece, and then this would be the audio. As you can see right there, there's some audio for the intro, and then that's the video. But if I wanted to, record post-production audio, I do it from in here too. It gives you all these options. You go into the audio, and basically like that. And I'll show you how it rolls through here. And all right, and you see it right there. You can hear it. Then it's gonna go to nothing because I have nothing in there. I deleted the videos that are in there. This is where I set up my bin for the video I'm gonna use. That was the videos that I deleted. Then this is my watermark. This is the name of the sequence, which is this part right here is actually the sequence. Then it has, you know, the intro, the outro, and all that stuff. And when I want to pick something, it's as easy as clicking on the video I want, making it pop up on the left hand side, and then hitting the space bar, and you'll see it roll up. Then all I gotta do is, if I want to just drag this whole thing, I just grab it and drag it right there, or not. And basically that's it. And then when I want to render something, say I want to render something, I just hit file, depending on the app that I'm using. This one uses, and I could actually use, I got Final, you'll see right there, I got Final Cut Pro, so I could use either way. And then you just go into media, and that's basically the render out. I pick the name right here. Where is it going to go to? Save to? You know, where is it going to save to? And then, you know, hit save, whatever. Then I render it out, and this app right there, the one that's in red, looks like a little folder right here. That'll open up by me hitting the queue button, and then it'll queue up in that app and render out. I think it gives you like 60 seconds before it auto renders. So that's that way. And then iMovie, same thing. Go to file on the left hand corner right here. You'll see that pop down. No, actually you go to share, and then it actually gives you things to where I want to do it at. You know, YouTube, Facebook, Vimeo, podcast producer. But I just go to export movie. It asks me like the resolution I want to pick it at and everything. And basically that's how I make my movies. And this is a quick tour. I don't want to open up Final Cut. So that's basically how I make movies and everything. I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to hit that thumbs up button if you want to see videos like this. And hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I got a lot more content, and this was just a brief overview on how I do my recording and everything like that. Hold on 1 second. I'm just gonna switch over to show you. Let's see, I have it set up for my HD PVR. So I want to show you the settings that I've. If you want to hear somebody's voice along with yours, if you got a mic or something, and you're doing in lag game recording, this is what you would do. You would set up your audio and then set up your say like your headset or whatever, your gaming headset. And you see how I have it astro out? Well, if you want people to hear that, the people talking, you put it on default device, and then the astro or whatever you're using. But when you're using, say you want to use the PS3 wireless 7.1, it won't record the audio, because the audio ends up going through the dongle stick, the USB dongle stick, and it doesn't let it go out through the RCA jacks for the sound. So stay away from doing this, because you won't get no audio. But if you're going to do like post-production commentary and you don't want no gameplay audio, well, you could use this too. So that's everything I have right now. Tell me what y'all think. Leave your comments down below. Hit that thumbs up button. It helps my channel grow. And also, I've gotten 1,500 subscribers, which took me forever and a day. I stayed at 1,400 subscribers forever. I mean, I think it was like 4 months from 1,400 to 1,500 subscribers. Anyways, I should have my other Multiplat Game Trap YouTube channel will be piggyback onto my partnership, and it will be partnered hopefully soon. And y'all will be able to, YouTube producers will be able to submit YouTube videos to be played on there, and they could become partner with that YouTube channel. And with if you have any people that edit, editors or anything, anybody that writes game reviews and anything like that, and want to do it, to be on my partnered up with me on my website, which is multiplatgametrap.com, which you probably already know, to put your content up there, get stuff like that. I'm actually in the process of submitting all of paperwork to different publishers and developers for commercial permission for gameplay on that channel. And so I won't have any, you know, copyright problems or anything like that. So if you're interested, just drop me a line. I'll leave my email address for you to get in contact with me in the description. That's all I have for you tonight, for today. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. And if you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.